Okay. Hey everyone, it's Pewee and Nim here with another awesome cast, and today we are actually going to be watching Liquid Tyler and Liquid TLO. So we got a little bit of a climb over here, see who has the best reputation in that team. Nim?
Yeah, hey guys. Today we're going to see another game that, like, Protoss versus Taren. Liquid TLO is a Taren player, and Tyler is going to be the Protoss player. And so what exactly are you expecting from these players? Is there, like, going to be maybe a domination from one of them, or do you think they're both, like, equally skilled, or...?
I personally, like, I'm a big fan of TLO as a character, as a personality. I don't really think he's that good.
Okay.
So I'm expecting Tyler to take this. I am expecting some a bit unorthodox and unconventional tactics from Mr. TLO, as always.
Mm-hmm.
But I personally think that Tyler will take it. Okay. What about you?
I'm hoping that TLO will win, but since I'm a fan of his, I think it's a cool guy, and well, just basically cool.
he's an awesome character, personality to watch.
But I have a feeling that TLO will win this, though. But yeah. I'm still hoping for TLO.
Definitely, and also it's quite sad with TLO at the moment. He's got carpal tunnel, hasn't he? So he's resting up.
Yeah, all of best. Hope that's something I won't be struggling in the future with, hopefully.
Yeah. Just gotta rest up. But luckily we are getting him cast in some games, like he done the TL Open, which is always fun.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so tactics wise, everything looks standard. Marines on their way, Cybercore on their way. One gas, the second gas isn't down, but I imagine it'll go down quite soon.
Yep.
Unless, of course, he expands. Oh, we're there yet. It's gonna go down with the next probe. There it is.
We got
a factory. From TLO, of course, not Tyler, in case you're checking that.
Yeah, I'll check that. So, you might see maybe a 101 build, maybe?
That's a possibility. It is a possibility. It's a bit doubtful with just one gas, unless he goes strictly Marines,
mm-hmm.
and doesn't spend any gas until he gets the starport.
Yep.
So, I doubt it. But we'll find out in about 20 seconds.
Yep.
From Tyler, we went for a sentry first. He didn't get a stalker. And his third unit is actually a Zealot, so he's not getting a stalker with that either.
He's actually going Robo as well.
Yeah, now he is. We've got a Hellion on the way.
Mm-hmm. What exactly is, I know Hellions is quite good against Zerg, but how exactly are they against Protoss?
They're not that great. They can be, like, if you have your units out of the way, like, like everything, they can do a lot of damage. There's things like force fields, you can't really do much against a force field, can you?
Mm-hmm. That's true.
And Stalkers have nice range to get them up early.
Yeah.
And it's obviously on our tactics where it's with Zergs, roaches, for hell, you just go roaches, and obviously you don't have roaches to carry on tech, and you have to build the roach war, and...
Yeah.
So it's normally, they're not really that great, unless you do a drop of them.
Okay.
And as unexpected, TLO is taking his command center, building it in base.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got tanks on the way. Interesting. So I think he just wanted one Hellion for a bit of vision and speed and map control.
Yeah, but Tyler has spotted already, as he had this probe was going to go and expand, but... Since TLO does have his Hellion, where he's going to expand,
it's
going to be stopping that for a little bit at least.
Yeah. But with that single Hellion, if you look at Tyler, he's kind of throwing him off his gist. He's got two Stalkers at the bottom of his ramp and his Observers heading in that direction, just in case a drop's come in.
Yeah.
So he's doing a little, you know, a couple mind games with him. The starboard is now on the way for TLO.
Mm-hmm.
He actually has 4 SUVs on his right gas.
Does he?
Yeah.
That's not good.
No, not at all.
He is researching siege tech as well. And it's just mainly just consisting of only Marines. Is that really a good choice? Isn't Marauders quite good against Protoss?
They're both you want, really. Marines are much better with Stim.
Mm-hmm.
But he's spending all his gas pretty much on tanks, and he's got his airport now, his starport, so he can't really afford the Marauders. So I'm not surprised he went for Marines.
Yeah, especially with the airport, yeah.
Yeah. The airport, man. He's got a Raven building.
That's quite surprising, but I guess... I'm always wondering, why isn't Terran players using more Ravens? You don't really need more than maybe 1 or 2 Ravens, so it should be quite sufficient.
Yeah, I think one is definitely a good idea. You always at least want one. A couple more I don't really see being a harm. I'm curious what he's going to build after that. Is he going to build Banshee? Or he might just swap it with the Barracks and then go for Stim.
I'm not sure if you're seeing this, but he's actually expanding again.
Yeah, he's building an extra command center. If he just builds that into an orbital and doesn't use it for a couple minutes, it's paid for itself with meals.
True.
Oh, the Observer's about to go down.
Yeah, so the Raven's already... making use of himself.
Yeah.
And
definitely.
Tyler has to move out a little bit with his Observer.
We got Banshee on its way.
Yeah.
We got nothing from the barracks or the factory being built, but we've got an extra 2 barracks going down.
Yeah, you have Hallucination and getting research from Protoss Play as well. It's good for both scouting and.
Have you seen this? He's got 2 starports. He's building another 2 starports. I think he's going to swap 1 starport with the reactor from the barracks.
Mm-hmm. There's both tech labs here. So, yeah.
Very strange.
That's very strange, James.
He's not going for cloak either.
Yeah, I'm a bit surprised, but he's not really sure exactly what he's doing. He's trying to get some probe kills with his blue-colored
helmets. Oh, he's gonna get some.
He's gotten 6 already by one of them.
Oh, nice lineup there.
Yeah, nice force field as well, basically killing off the 4 Hellions.
No, it's just 2 out of the other ones escaped, didn't they?
No, I think
did he kill them?
They killed all of them.
Ah, then that actually wasn't cost efficient. He lost 4 Hellions, 6 SCVs.
Yeah, and now Tyler is moving out as well with force. He has quite a lot of Immortals in his army. And he's actually going for a gold base.
That's no surprise. He's turning it into an orbital.
He'd cancel it, but just not enough.
Gonna lose it.
Yeah, he just lost it as well.
He didn't even load it straight away. The mortal's gone damaged it.
Yeah.
Make sure it finished. That's a lot of banshees. And he's going for another command center straight away. He's got another starport.
Did you see this? He's doing 5 hallucinations with immortals, and he's pushing out with the hallucinator first.
Yeah. The first 3 immortals, though, are real.
That's a good game by Tyler there.
Yeah, he's got the Raven, so you can...
Yeah.
That was a bit anticlimactic, man.
I was expecting quite a lot more
God.
Of this. Wasn't really expecting a fast game.
Yeah, well, Tyler had 1,200 minerals and 500 gas left at the end.
Yeah,
so that...
That's
very inefficient. Like, I'm a big fan of Tyler... TLO, just because, you know, the Team Liquid and all that.
Yeah.
But personally, they're far from the top of their game. Like, Tyler especially, like, he has a reputation for being a bit of a boss. and the last few months I haven't seen anything impressive. Home Story Cup, TSL, nothing. He gets out, knocked out like straight away. Even MLG, he didn't do well. He was like 0-4, 0-5.
Yeah, it's disappointing. But yeah, also expecting a bit better match between these guys. But
yeah, definitely.
Maybe in the future we can see more. So again, thanks guys for tuning in, and we'll see you guys next time.
Yeah, hopefully.
Yeah.
Take care, guys.